the transport sector here in Rwanda contributes 60% in terms of the general emissions in the country. We think we can help the country move from fossil fuel-based mobility to green mobility.
Jerry Ndayishimiye is part of a new generation, transitioning Rwanda's economy to a more sustainable electric future.
We offer the electric vehicles themselves, we offer green mobility solutions for goods and people, and we offer a charging infrastructure.
It's a big challenge, and he's not doing it alone.
We have tax incentives, duty-free, excess duty-free, no VAT, and all this is helping us in terms of reducing the end consumer price.
This is a charging infrastructure. Yeah. You plug it there and then it charges the
Jerry's startup is growing, thanks to help from the Rwandan government.
You can't talk about economy without taking care of environment. Rwanda has chosen to put environment at the heart of everything we do. We have set a target to reduce by 38% our greenhouse gas emission by 2030.
Rwanda's climate goals are being supported by a new IMF initiative. The Resilience and Sustainability Trust offers long-term affordable financing, helping low-income and vulnerable middle-income countries.
Rwanda is the first African country to benefit from the new Resilience and Sustainability Trust, and it has decided to invite neighbors and put in front of them their own experience as an example for them to follow.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this morning's roundtable discussions.
Some people may not understand it. Why is IMF involved in the climate change and the climate financing? It is because the impact on our economies is huge.
For the last 4 years, we have been hit by flood. Drought and flooding are very disastrous, and they affect the economies negatively.
And from my own country, Kenya, we are actually going through the worst drought in the last 40 years. There is a challenge, given that most countries are struggling, given the debt levels they have. So there is no fiscal space.
Africa has contributed very little to the problem. But Africa is already suffering the consequences of climate change in a very dramatic way.
Good afternoon. Welcome to our very youthful corner with the good air. So my name is Ineza, but as you know, you're here.
For Rwanda's young climate activist, meeting the challenges of a changing planet is no longer a choice.
Don't mess up this time, because there's no more excuse left on the table. Science is clear, the human impact isn't clear, and the innovation is available. We all know that we have a responsibility. We just want to be all part of a solution today, now.